The latest and greatest budget smartphone from Blue is the Vivo XL4. It retails for $150, but for a limited time, the company is selling it for $100. I'll place a link in the description if you want to check out the deal. We have the XL4 in the studio. Having checked out many other Blue smartphones in the past, the first thing that really got my attention was the box. I love the gold and black graffiti design. If this thing were going to be sitting on store shelves, it would certainly stand out. Inside the box, we'll see the XL4 keeps with the Blue tradition of shipping devices with an abundant supply of accessories. We have a wall wart, a micro USB charging cable, a get started guide, pair of earphones, a screen protector, two silicone protective cases, a sticker, and a SIM card ejector tool. I am really disappointed to see that this phone must be charged with a micro USB charging cable. We're on the verge of 2019. There's no reason to ship a smartphone without a USB-C charging cable, in my opinion. With that said, there are some more modern features included in this handset. For example, we'll see a 6.2-inch display that takes up most of the front of the phone and even includes a notch, because that's the thing to do these days. The downside is that there is a relatively big bottom lip, and the resolution only measures in at 720 by 1500 pixels, translating to a relatively low 271 pixel per inch index. The brightness doesn't appear particularly great, but viewing angles and colors look good. Taking a step back, I will say the phone feels very solid in the hands. It has a nice weight to it that doesn't scream cheap or hollow. I assume the aluminum metal back design has something to do with this. We do have a headphone jack, which is nice to see, but I do not like to see the micro USB charging port or back-facing speakers that can easily get covered up by your hands. The XL4 runs Android 8.1 Oreo out of the box. My guess is that it's not going to get Android Pie, otherwise it would already ship with it installed, but I'll have to confirm with Blue and update the description. We will see a custom launcher with support for Google Now and an app drawer by default. A long press will bring up some settings like the ability to arrange apps and search for apps. You can double press on any open area of the home screen to put the display to sleep. There are also some gestures like swipe down to open up the notification panel or search for apps. Based off first impressions, the phone runs fairly well. It's equipped with an octa-core MediaTek Helio P22 processor with 3 GB of RAM and 32 GB of internal storage. Now, I have noticed some herky-jerky animations and some lag that I'm not used to experiencing with phones that cost several hundred dollars or more. For $150 or $100 with this limited time deal, I think it should perform well enough and be able to handle light gaming, web browsing, and social media apps just fine. On the rear, there is a 13-megapixel main shooter with a 2-megapixel telephoto sensor that will help retain quality when capturing zoomed-in photos. There's also a 13-megapixel front-facing sensor. You have portrait mode, a wide-angle selfie mode, several different picture sizes and timers. If you don't expect too much from the cameras, they should serve you well. My personal favorite feature of the XL4 is the 4,000 milliamp hour battery with quick charging support. With its more moderate specs, this phone should easily last you 1 to 2 full days of moderate to heavy usage per charge. So the biggest downside I see with the XL4 is the lack of software updates. Blue doesn't have a good track record with delivering timely updates, but they have made a recent effort to ship fewer devices and send out more updates to prolong the life of their current smartphones. Time will tell if the XL4 is one of those devices to receive extended support. For what it's worth, I did get an update to install the latest Google security patch for November, but that could very well be it. Buy this phone though with the very likely possibility that it will not be updated to Android Pie. With that said, if you're interested, I'll place a link in the description to pick it up for $100 for a limited time. You really can't beat that price. If you don't act soon, it will shoot back up to around $150, which may make it more of a tough sell. It's available for GSM carriers like T-Mobile and AT&T, and comes in black and gold color configurations.